My life, my inspiration. My life is my inspiration. Many may be tempted to think that this is fabricated, but it is not embellished. It is my raw experience. I still find it difficult to believe that she is my mother. Yes, I find it impossible to live with. Maybe my father is still in the dark about how he's not my real father. I am a young lady, first born for that matter, in a family of four daughters. Growing up was very rough and tough for me. By the age of eight, I would question myself every single day as to what I could have possibly done to make her hate me so much, to award myself with so much favor and hatred from the one person that was supposed to shield and protect me with her life. I moved on to many stages of negativity in my life. First, it was self-hatred. I mean, I must have done something in those 8 years to make her hate me so much. No amount of gifts could buy her love. I could not convince her to love me. I moved on to loathing. I loathed her for the times that I needed her and she shunned me. I could not forgive her for choosing everyone over me, especially when I needed her. I was just a child and I needed her love, not her neglect. Why is it that my father performed roles of both parents? Now as a teenager, I had to tell myself it was up to me to decide if someone who openly affirmed that she hated me, someone who told everyone around her that she regretted having me, destroy my life, or use that pain as my strength and motivation. By 14 years old, I knew that the only way out was to excel in my academics. What I lacked in motherly love, I made up for in intellectual. I used my brain. My brain was going to be my motivation. My brain was going to be my inspiration, my one-way ticket to freedom. Yeah. And so, by painting smiles that hit the heartache I experienced every day, and feeding on the sweat, blood, and sacrifice of my father, and the criticism that came from my mother, I worked. As a result of my brain, my inspiration, I graduated gallantly with the highest Cambridge results in my high school. And as a result, I was awarded a 100% scholarship at my university. My brain had inspired me. Now as I look back, it is safe to say that the emotional strain that I went through did not destroy me as a person. It is those same predicaments that had me crying myself to sleep every single night that drew me a thick skin. It is the ache that I would feel in my heart when my three-year-old sister would scold my mother for stressing me, or her little hugs as she told me not to cry and that she loved me, that made me strong. Today, my thick skin enables me to be there for my friends and my family when they need me. Because of the thick skin that I grew, I am able to face any challenges as they come. I have been through worse, so I accept anything as it comes, because I will not back down. And my God is paramount. If it was not for His grace and mercy, I do not know where I would be in this life. Many a time I have been at my lowest, and I felt like death is simpler. But it is those times that something spectacular happens, and God reaffirms His love and presence in my life. Many a time on this island, I have slept on an empty stomach or had one meal per day. I honestly thought I would go crazy. I had given up. But God shows me His miracles and His love, His unconditional love, His agape love. And that is why I am standing here today. As I stand before you, I am not a victim of circumstance. No. Neither am I a challenge case. I am a testimony of greatness and will through God's power. And I am my father's daughter, and I will make him proud. I will never back down, because I am the light and by at the end of my own tunnel. For me, every day above ground is a good day, because I know I have another chance to further myself, and that is my life.
Oh,